Good morning, dear children. Welcome back to Maths class. I hope all of you are fine and healthy. Already you have taken the chapter fractions. Already you have taken the notes, fractions. I will divide this chapter into two parts. Today I will do the videos of part 1. Next part you can see in the next week. Understood? Already the notes is completed. You have taken. Now I am going to revise this first part of fractions. So what do you mean by fractions? Fraction is a part of a whole. Suppose a circle is given. I am dividing this circle into four parts. So if I shade this part, I am taking out one part from four part. If I shade two parts, what it indicates? Out of four parts, I have shaded two parts. If I shade three parts, how to write? Out of four parts, I shaded three parts. How many parts remains here? One part remains. How to write in the form of a numbers called as fractions? What is fraction? Fraction is a part of whole. Suppose we are dividing the apple into two parts. We are dividing dosa into two parts. Each part indicates the fraction of the whole thing. So what is fraction? Fraction is a part of whole. Fraction is a part of whole. Fraction is a part of whole. So let us discuss in this chapter fractions on number line. Fractions on number line. What is the meaning of number line? Representation of numbers on a line. Suppose this is the line. At the center 0 and you go rightwards, each point indicates plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. When you come leftwards, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This is called as the number line. Representation of integers on a line. Representation of integers on a line is called as number line. In this, on the same line, we need to represent the fraction. For example, represent 4 by 7. This example you have taken, I think. Represent 4 by 7. How to represent 4 by 7? So, 7, out of 7 part, we need to represent 4. At that time, what we need to do is, this is the number line. If it is plus 12 is given, no need of minus 12 taking, that is 0. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Understood? Out of 7 part, we need to represent 4. Or we will write some most of the times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If I locate this point, it indicates actually 4, where if it is integer. If it is integer, it indicates 4. Represent 4 on a number line means this is the answer. Now it is represent 4 by 7. So this value we should not write. Understood? This value we should not write. Suppose this is 0. Let's consider this as 1. In between these, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Out of 7 part, we need to represent 4 means 1, 2, 3, 4. This indicates 4 divided by 7. Clear? In the same figure, represent 3 by 7 means you need to locate this point 3 divided by 7. Here 7 is full thing. Out of 7, we need to represent 4. That's the question. Understood? This is called as representation of fractions on a number line. So sometimes questions they will ask, find 3 by 4 of 12. Finding the fractions. Find 3 by 4 of 12. What is the meaning of this? Of indicates multiplication. 3 by 4 of 12. What is the answer? Their question. The answer is 4 ones are 4, 3 is 3, 3 is 9. Suppose find 6 by 3 of 18. What will you do? 6 by 3 into 18. Of means what? Into 3 ones are 3, 6 are 6, 6 are 36. Like this. Understood? So this is called as finding the fractions. So multiplication of fraction and whole number. Or sometimes they'll ask, find 3 by 4 of 12 means we need to find the whole number. So 3 by 4 into 12 or 6 by 3 into 18 will get the whole number. Next, types of fractions. You might have heard different types are there. In that, I will take up the first one is a proper fraction. Proper. It is a fraction. Fraction is part of whole thing. It will be written in the form of 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4. It consists of numerator and denominator. So what is proper fraction? Proper fraction is a fraction in this numerator is less than the denominator. So numerator is always less than the denominator. 2 by 3. Here this is called as numerator. This is called as denominator. Always numerator is less than denominator. Such a fraction is called as proper fraction. For example, 2 by 3. Whether 1 by 4 is a fraction, proper fraction? Yes. 2 by 8 is a proper fraction? Yes. 7 by 12 is a proper fraction? Yes. Because numerator is less than denominator. Proper fraction is a part of, a kind of fractions. In this, numerator is less than denominator. Second one, improper. What is the meaning of improper? Again, improper fraction is a fraction. In this, numerator is greater than the denominator. Numerator is greater than the denominator. Suppose it is numerator and denominator. Numerator is greater than the denominator. Sometimes it may be equal also. Sometimes it may be equal also. 2 by 2. It is a improper fraction. Sometimes equal. Most of the time, numerator is greater than the denominator. If it is equal, then this also is improper. If numerator is less, then it is called as proper. Numerator is less, proper. Numerator and denominators are equal or numerator is greater, then it is called as improper. The third one is called as mixed fraction. Mixed. What is the meaning of mixed fraction? Mixed fraction is a combination of whole and combination of whole number and proper fraction. Combination of whole and proper fraction. So what is the answer? Combination of whole means whole number. 1, 1 by 2. 2, 2 by 3. 4, 3 by 4. This is called as a mixed fraction. For example, convert 1, 1 by 2 into improper fraction. How we can convert this into improper fraction? So 1, 1 by 2 is given. It is a combination of how to read 1 integer 1 by 2. If it is 2, 2 by 3, 2 integer 2 by 3, 4 integer 3 by 4, or 1, 1 by 2, 2 by 3, 4, 3 by 4, like that. So here 1 integer 1 by 2, 1 is a whole number, it is a proper fraction. So what is the denominator? Denominator is 2. If it is like this, what do we need to do? We need to multiply this. 2 1s are 2, 1s are 2. What? 2 1s are 2 plus 1 you need to add. Understood? How to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction, if 1 by 1 1, 1 by 2 is given, means 2 is the denominator. Next, this 2 you should multiply here, 2 ones are, plus add the numerator. So it is how much? 2 ones are 2 plus 1 by 2, that is 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2, whether it is improper? Yes. Suppose the question is 4, 6 by 7, how to write? 7 is the denominator, 7 and 4 you need to multiply, plus add the numerator. 4 sevens are 28, plus 6 by 7, that is equal to 28 plus 6 is 34 by 7, it is an improper fraction. Next, equivalent fractions. What is the meaning of equivalent fractions? Equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions are a fraction in this. Suppose 1 by 2 is given. Write the equivalent fractions of 1 by 2. I will write several equivalent fractions because 1 by 2 can be written as 1 by 2 into, we can multiply, add, divide any numbers. 1 by 2 equivalent fraction is 1 by 2 into, I will write 3 by 3. Equivalent fractions of 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 into 4 by 4. I can write any numbers. If you multiply means you should divide, so that it gets cancelled. 1 by 2 remains as it is. 1 by 2 remains as it is. 1 by 2 remains as it is. This is equal to what? 1 2's are 2 divided by 2 2's are 4. 1 3's are 3 divided by 2 3's are 6. 4 1's are 4 by 2. 4's are 8. So, 2 by 4, 3 by 6, 4 by 8 are equivalent fractions of which one? 1 by 2. Whether I have only 3 equivalent fractions? No, there are several equivalent fractions. How to find? For the given number, suppose the given number is 7 by 8. How to find the equivalent fraction? For 7 by 8, multiply and divide the same thing. Multiply and divide the same thing so that you will get the equivalent fraction. Clear? 8 to the 16, 7 to the 14, 3. 7 is 21, 8 is 24, 7 4 is 28, 8 4 is 32. These are equivalent fractions of 7 by 8. The last concept is comparison of fractions. Comparison of fractions. How we can compare? How we can say which fraction is greater than which one? How we can say if two fractions are given, which is the greater one, which is the smaller one? Suppose the question is 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6. If the given fraction is of the form 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, these fractions are called as like fractions. Why you can say? Because the denominator is same. If denominators are same, then the fractions are called as like fractions. Easily we can say which is greater one. Just compare the numerator. Which is greater? 9 by 6 is the greater. Which is the smaller one in this? 3 by 6 is the smaller. It is very easy. Suppose like fractions given, easily we can say denominators are same. Just compare the numerator. Which is the greater one? That is the greater fraction. Which is the lesser one? That is the smaller fraction. Now, suppose the question is related to unlike fractions. Unlike fractions. How we can find? Suppose 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 5 by 8. Which is greater here? At this time it is very difficult to find out because it is unlike fractions. Denominators are different. How we can say which fraction is greater, which fraction is smaller? First we need to make this fraction as like fractions by making the denominators same. How we can make denominators same? By taking LCM. LCM of 2, 4 and 8. How to find? Suppose 2, 4 and 8 is given. Divided by 2. 2 ones are, 2 twos are, 2 fours are. Again, divided by 2. 1 to go, keep as it is. 2 ones are, 2 twos are. If you multiply these 2, sorry, this all will get LCM. 2 twos are 4, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So, 1 by 2 can be written as 1 by 2. If we need to multiply, if we need to make denominator as 8. Denominator as 8, what you need to multiply? We need to multiply 4. Isn't it? It is equal to 4 divided by 8. Clear? Suppose 3 by 4 is given. We need to make denominator as 8. What you need to multiply? 2 we need to multiply. So here also multiply 2 and 3. That is 6 by 8. Last one. 5 by 8 is given. Already 8 is in the numerator. No problem. For denominator, no problem. 5 keep as it is. Now compare these three. Denominators are same. Which is the greater one? Whether 4 or 6 or 5. This is the greater one. Easily we can say 8 by 6 is greater fraction. Which is smaller one? 4 by 8 is smaller one. What is the answer we need to give? 6 by 8. What is the 6 by 8 here? 3 by 4 is the greater one. 4 by 8 means 1 by 2 is the smaller one. Clear? So I hope this concept clear. Some more concept remains. I will take that part in the next videos. You understood these concepts. Already you have taken notes. Go through this video as well as try to solve the exercise problems. Thank you.